Hello everybody and welcome to day two of Vlogmas. Today we're going to be making the top for my Christmas outfit and we are going to be using a old pattern that I got from my school. Here you can see that I am just tracing out the pattern so that I can use it to alter to make the shirt that I'm going to make. Well, we've got a lot to do, a lot to discuss, so let's get to it, shall we? Working on the back of the pattern, and I simply traced the back and the yoke. The yoke is the top portion of the back, and then I am adjusting the sleeve here. I wanted it to be a little bit smaller because this pattern is for men's, so I shortened it by an inch, adjusted it, cut out the yoke so that I could use it to adjust the back portion of the top. So here I'm being stupid and trying to adjust it without adding the seam allowance, so I add the seam allowance. Makes it a lot easier, you know, when you do things properly. And then I used my little curved hem ruler, and I quickly adjusted that to be the same. And then here I'm just cutting out the other yoke, and we have the finished back pieces. Here I have no idea what's going on, honestly. It looks like an earthquake is hitting, but it's okay because my camera was dead, so I had to film this with my phone. So here we are with an actual good shot of me trying to draw this line, and then here I move the ruler up so I can finish the hem, and then you're about to see it cut off because I dropped my phone. And now we're cutting out the front pieces. After I finished adjusting the sleeve, I did it the same way I did the back. And then here I'm just finishing cutting up. The cutting took so long. It took about probably 2 hours, maybe more, honestly, I'm not sure. After adjusting one side of the front, I adjusted the other side of the front, and now I'm labeling it because Lord knows I will forget which side is which. Mostly because I have a problem distinguishing my right from my left sometimes, like a child, but it's fine. But now we're gonna do the collar, and I did cut this out on the bias because I needed a little extra stretch around the neck. And then we're also going to cut out the sleeve placket and the cuffs at this point. Here we have a bell sleeve that I already had, and then I just shortened it, and then I adjusted the cap of the sleeve. Here I'm drawing the finish line, and then another earthquake happens because I'm holding this phone with my chin. Honestly, I don't know how I did that, but we're moving on. Here comes the cleanest transition I have ever done in my entire life. Now we're going to take that same sleeve pattern after cutting out both of these sleeves. We're going to basically center it, and then we're going to shift it down so I can draw the line for the sleeve placket. And then I do end up cutting these slits open so that they are ready for the next day. Time to go to work.
Hello, Floofy. Oh, he's so fluffy, but you need to get out of the way now. All right, so now we're going to be sewing it, and we're going to start with the yoke in the back, and here I'm just pinning the first one, and I'm going to sew it, and hello, it's sewing the magic of digital editing. Now we're going to sew the other side, and we're just going to sew to the opposite, and here we go. Honestly, if I was smarter, I would have sewn the shoulder together before I did this, but you know, whatever. It just makes things, it doesn't make things more difficult, but it doesn't make things easier. It's kind of one of those things where it doesn't really matter if you did it backwards or not. Now I'm just sewing down the yoke so that it stays nice and pretty and it stays in place. So here we are, we're going, and now we're done. And so here is the final back piece. So here I'm going to do a quick zoom in, and then you can see the lines that I'm going to be pressing so that I can stitch it like this. How pretty. Here comes another transition. We're going to sew the shoulder seams now. Remember how I was talking about earlier how it would have been more beneficial for me to do this first? Well, that is because of the method that I have to use in order to close these. Because I have the two pieces of yoke, I have to use this method called the burrito method, and it's just a pain in the butt. As you can see, I forgot how to do it because it's one of those things, it's kind of like pants. I forget how to do it, and then I have to sit there for 5 minutes and remember how to sew it. So once I did eventually remember how to sew it, we went ahead and we sewed that together. And as you can see, when they named this method, they weren't being really creative because it does look like a big fat burrito. But once you're done, you get a clean inside and a clean outside. Here I'm doing the same thing I did on the yoke in the back. I'm just sewing it down so that it looks all pretty and stays in place. Now we get to do the fun part, which is adding the sleeves. I forgot to mark the back on one of the sleeves, so that's what I'm doing there. And then I lined it up, and now you have to sew a line, a basting stitch really, so that you can gather the sleeve, because the sleeve, again, is bigger than the armhole, in theory at least, and it did end up being bigger. So now I'm just going to pin it in place so that I can sew it down. And yes, I am sewing this sleeve the easy way because I don't hate myself. So we are going to do that. Once we get that done, we are going to sew the other sleeve in place, just using the exact same method that we just did. So once that is sewn in place, we're going to be finishing the seams. Now, my serger is broken, which is a huge inconvenience because, well, sergers make everything less difficult. And honestly, I should have seen this coming because my serger's been broken for probably almost 2 years now, but I haven't needed it because I just use the ones at school. But unfortunately, that is not an option anymore. So I'm using Twill tape to finish the edges. So all I'm doing it is sewing it to the seam allowance at this point, because I'm going to fold it over once it's sewn down so that I can sew it to the back side of the garment, making a nice clean finish on the inside. And this was actually rather difficult to do, especially around the cap of the sleeve, which is the top of the sleeve. But once it was finished, it looked great, guys, and I was super proud of the results. And now I have to, unfortunately, do it again on the other side. Honestly, at first, I didn't think this would work, and I'd have to, like, double it on each side, so then I'd have to, like, sandwich the seam allowance in between the tell tape, but I am super happy that it did actually work out like this. And once it did get finished, I can sew the side seams and the sleeves together. I ended up finishing the seams the same way I did the sleeve seams. So once I sewed this, I took the twill tape again, and I sewed the twill tape all the way down the sleeves, and then I sewed the twill tape for the sleeves down to the sleeves. I can do this because the sleeves on this are very wide. If you have very thin sleeves, I don't suggest trying to do this. You might be able to, but it's going to definitely be very difficult, and you might end up hating your life decisions. So I would suggest, if you don't have a serger and you're doing something like this with thin sleeves, maybe French seaming it would probably be the better option, or you can always just regularly sew it down and then you can use a zigzag stitch to kind of finish it. Unless you're using maybe a synthetic fiber, then you could just melt the edges and that would do the exact same effect as a serger. And as you can see, because the sleeve is so wide, I was able to do it, but I had to like pull the fabric forward in order to prevent it from going underneath the machine. As you can see from the zoom in that I did, was going to originally press it and then sew it to the sleeve, but I had a lapse in memory and ended up doing it a different way that ended up not working at all. So here's what happened because of my poor judgment. The original way I was going to do the cuff is actually the correct way. I thought for some reason that my placket here was supposed to go over the sleeve slit and the cuff. I had a lapse in memory because the last time I did this pattern, again, it was like 2 years ago. The original way I was going to do this was correct. I'm going to take out just the ends of the cuff here so that I can fold them inwards. And also I'm going to take them off so that I can put this placket in. It'll turn out looking the exact same. It's not really that much of a hassle. We're gonna get the seam ripper out again, and we're going to take out those cuffs, and we're gonna put the pockets in.
So to talk about this sad slaga of the sleeve cuffs, I ended up taking out that little portion on each side of the cuff so that I could put in the sleeve placket, and after struggling to remember how to do this sleeve placket, I eventually got it done, but not before remembering that I actually have to remove the entire cuff, so this is how that went.
I finally fixed it. It looks way better now. Gorgeous. But my camera is almost dead, and I still have to do the collar and hem it. So we're going to do that very quickly because I am getting hungry. So let's get on that.
So the collar was relatively simple. After I got my fabric laid out to where I wanted, I did the collar the same way I ended up doing the cuffs. I just pressed it in half, and then I pressed the seam allowance up on one end, and then I stitched it down to one side of the collar, and then after sewing that down, I sewed down the other side so that I could create the full collar. Now I'm just testing to make sure that it's at the going to be hemmed at the proper length. It didn't line up for some reason right here, even though it actually does line up. Once I laid it down on the ground, it lined up perfectly fine, so I'm not sure what was going on there, but I did test the sleeve cuffs too to make sure that they were fitting nice and properly. The front of the neck looked great as well, so then I started on hemming it. This took a very short little amount of time. Once I pressed it to where I needed it to be, it was about an inch and a half for the hem. I just quickly did that on my cover stitch, and now I'm going to give it another try on.
Okay. All right. Beautiful. Super cute. All right, I'm done. It's finished. All I had to do is the buttons. I don't have the buttons. I left them in my boyfriend's car. So I will do the buttons when I do his shirt. But it looks good. It looks super cute. Gotta do the buttons. Yeah, we're done. That's it for today's vlog. I'll see you next time, tomorrow, or in part 2 of making our Christmas outfits.